Great to have you join. In this video, we will add an external asset to our theme. Take note that the process of adding assets is similar regardless of whether you are adding CSS, JavaScript, or something else. Like always, be mindful that you can pause the video as you do your own work. Let's begin. Ultimately, the external asset we are going to add is going to be an external Google font called Pacifico. Go ahead and open up the simplesmart.libraries.yaml file in your code editor. When you are ready, enter the following declaration below the global CSS assets. Pay attention to any indentation. We'll talk about each line here in a moment. The first key of Pacifico is the container name for this asset. We will refer to this when you update our info.yaml file shortly. The next key of license provides details of the license of the assets along with a URL to the details of it. Be mindful of the spelling of license. Next is the familiar key of CSS. Take note that this key would be JS if you are adding a JavaScript asset. Then is the key of theme, and here is where it gets interesting. How this URL of fonts.googleapis.com is typed is not a mistake. These two slashes make Drupal fetch the external asset with the same protocol that matches the Drupal page. The HTTPS or the HTTP prefix is dropped, making this URL a protocol relative URL. You can add the appropriate protocol if it's needed, in which case, you would type out the full URL, including the HTTPS or HTTP protocol as needed. Within this same line, in the attributes section, be sure to include that this is an asset of type external. The final line here points to a styles CSS file, which we will create in just a bit. The attributes area of this line is empty, which implies that this asset is internal. After you have double-checked your code, be sure to save the file. When you are ready, after saving, go ahead and open up the simplesmart.info.yaml file. When your info.yaml file is ready, enter the following line to the library's key so that Drupal knows about our newly added Google font asset. This should be entered below the global CSS asset container we defined earlier. Make sure there is only one space between the dash and the text of SimpleSmart. When you are ready, be sure to save the file. Excellent! Now that we have told Drupal to use the Pacifico asset library we defined in the libraries.yaml file, if we go back to examine the Pacifico container, we'll notice that we also included a styles.css file. Here is where we include the styles.css file. Let's create this file now. Within the CSS directory of your SimpleSmart theme, create a new file called styles.css. Great. After you have created the file, place the following basic CSS code within it. Nice job. When you're ready, be sure to save the file. Now, let's test our external Google font asset by clearing the cache on our Drupal site. Go ahead and open your site in your browser now. Here at the site, let's flush the cache using the admin toolbar. Awesome! You can now see that the site is using the external Google font asset. Congratulations! Remember, adding an external asset is similar to adding an internal asset, with the additional attribute required indicating that the asset is of type external. Great job. See you in the next videos. Happy learning.